answers are highly respected among my people, but I get the feeling these women are not held in high esteem.
Word on the street is that you've been busy. Congratulations on taking down Fist. I was sure he was a big player in anything going on here. Did you find anything in his office that could help me?
These OSDs might have the information you're looking for.
You've got Fist's files? This could be even bigger than I'd hoped. Here, Commander, for your trouble.
What would my future cooperation be worth? Say, an interview when my investigation is over?
Exclusive? You talk to me before you talk to anyone else? That would be worth quite a bit, and I'd be very happy to compensate you accordingly. Here you are. Now, if you'll excuse me, I should go see what's on these discs.
I could get used to living like this.
I need those supplies for my clinic. I can't.
You can and you will, or your story won't stay secret for long. Don't disappoint me, Doctor.
Oh, Commander Shepard, I didn't see you come in.
Every time I come in here, I see someone threatening you. Who was that?
Someone from my past. I can take care of it.
I might be able to help you.
I was fired by my previous employer for giving out free medical supplies to clinics like this. They never filed any charges, they just wanted me to leave without any fuss. But somebody must have found out. Now they are blackmailing me. I have to give them what they want. If the board finds out about my past, I could lose my license, they'll shut my clinic down.
Maybe I can get you out of this. Tell me what they want.
I have to give some of my medical supplies to a merchant in the markets. They expect delivery today.
Give me your contact's name. I'll deal with this guy, whoever he is.
Deal with him? But won't they expose my past?
I'll make sure they don't tell anyone.
I was told to speak with a merchant named Morlan, down in the markets. I really appreciate this, Commander. Thank you.
Don't worry. I'll take care of this.
Good luck, Commander. Be careful down there.
Hello there. Welcome to Moreland's famous shop. You want many good supplies, yes?
You were expecting a delivery of medical supplies?
But I was told the doctor would be bringing them.
Things have changed, Morlun.
A change, but the doctor... This is not right, human.
Shut up, Morlun. I told Baines you'd screw this up.
What the hell's going on here? Who are you?
Leave the doctor alone.
We can end this if you just bring me those supplies. Otherwise, I'll start telling people about the doctor's little secret.
You're shutting down a medical clinic. What if someone needs treatment? What if you need treatment?
Hey, hold on! I'm just the middleman here. This is way more than I bargained for.
Thank you, human. It is good to see him humbled so.
What do you know about Baines?
I have never met him, human. I only worked with the one who spoke with the doctor.
Goodbye.
Yes, all right then. Good tidings to you, human.
Commander, how did things go?
He won't be bothering you anymore.
Really? That's a great relief, Commander. Thank you. I can't pay you for your help, but I can give you a discount on any supplies you purchase here.
The thug said he worked for a man named Baines. Sound familiar?
Baines? I wonder if he means Armiston Baines. We worked together a long time ago.
What can you tell me about him?
Last I heard, the Alliance military was contracting him for some research in the Traverse.
I wonder if the captain knows him.
We'll see what the captain can tell us.
I wish I could tell you more. Is there anything else I can help you with, Commander?
I'll be going now.
Goodbye, Commander. Nice talking to you.
Yeah, what is it?
Why were you tossed out of there?
Doran didn't have a clue what I was doing. He assumed I was cheating.
You were cheating, though, weren't you?
I was just tipping the scales in my favor. Only as an experiment.
It still sounds like cheating to me.
To you, maybe. But this device is merely intended to simulate situations and record results. Recording losses is easy, of course. Nobody notices those.
Why do you need to record these outcomes?
Ah, now you're getting to the heart of it. I've spent the last 5 years developing a system that can accurately predict wins and losses on the Quasar. I just need a few more recorded wins and I can complete the algorithms.
Can you do that? Isn't that illegal?
It's illegal to use my system, but I won't use it. I'll sell it to others. I just need a few more wins recorded.
Does the device help me win?
The device is set to emit a frequency that will slightly increase your odds. Nothing like my system eventually will, but enough to allow you to record your wins more quickly.
What's in this for me?
Keep your winnings. That should be payment enough, I think.
I'll help you out.
Huh. I suppose I could let you try it. Here you go. When you've recorded enough wins, it'll let you know. Of course, if you get caught with the device, well, you saw what happened to me. Well, off you go. That data won't collect itself.
It's not what I heard.
And what did you hear exactly?
More rumors about strange metal creatures with real AI.
Yes, but there's more.
Yeah, there always is.
I heard they had some connection with a rogue specter.
Not this again.
Why is that so hard to believe?
Whatever you say, just don't expect us to believe it too.
Hey, Jenna came back looking for work. Thanks for getting her out of Chora's den.
I was glad to help out.
Yeah, everyone seems real happy to have her back.
You don't sound that happy about it.
I'm glad she's out of the den. I'd just forgotten what it was like to have her around. I haven't had a decent tip since she got back.
Hey there, welcome to Flux.
Don't often see someone getting as lucky as you. Hello again. Can I help you?
I've got something you might be interested in.
Let me see that. You got that from Schells, didn't you? I saw him using it earlier. Tossed him out on his ass for it, too. Thanks for bringing this to me.
Cheaters shouldn't prosper.
I agree with you on that. Thanks again. Take a few shots at the quasar on the house.
I should be going.
Enjoy your time here at Flux.
I still can't believe that could happen out in the open.
So, did you record 5 wins with the device yet?
Actually, I gave your device to Doran.
But that was years of work. What am I gonna do now?
You could put your talents to better use.
You're no help at all. This is absolutely the worst day of my life.
This place is a little too perfect. They're hiding something.
So much empty space. 1,000 of my people could live here and hardly even see each other.
Rearranged 5 times now.
5 times? Why? What do they want?
How should I know? It's not like keepers offer an explanation for what they're doing.
And yet, everyone just lets them go on doing whatever it is they do.
What choice do we have? If you try to stop them, they just shut down and another one replaces it.
Just strange that we know so little about them.
Not to mention frustrating.
Welcome to Presidium Tourism Terminal 3. Here in the Financial District, a number of businesses offer various goods and services to their exclusive clientele. The statue you see before you was commissioned to honor the Krogan soldiers who gave their lives to protect Citadel space during the Rachni Wars. In the aftermath of the Krogan rebellions, several embassies petitioned to have the statue removed. However, this motion was eventually quashed by the Council.
Tell me more about the Krogan rebellions.
In recognition of their efforts during the Rachni Wars, the Krogan were granted several new colony worlds by the Council. Over the next 400 years, the Krogan species began to expand. Blessed with an extremely high birth rate, their numbers began to swell. Faced with a critical overpopulation crisis, the Krogan started a violent colonization of nearby worlds inhabited by other Council species. The Krogan rebellions had begun. For a full century, the Council and its member species fought to bring the Krogan under control. With the aid of the newly discovered Turian Empire, they were ultimately successful.
You needed the Krogan to stop the Rachni, then you needed the Turians to stop the Krogan. So who's going to stop the Turians?
I am sorry, but that question is beyond my programming parameters. The Turians are members of the Citadel Council. They are not a threat to galactic peace.
Why did the Council fight so hard to keep the statue?
The Krogan were instrumental in saving the galaxy from the Rachni threat. The Council believed this historical fact should not be forgotten. The Council also hoped that preserving the memorial would improve diplomatic relations with the Krogan and bring about a peaceful resolution to the rebellions. Unfortunately, the Krogan refused to negotiate and only surrendered after their population and homeworlds had been ravaged by the Turians.
What were the Rachni Wars?
Nearly 2,200 years ago, explorers seeking to expand Citadel space opened up mass relays leading to systems controlled by the Rachni. a highly intelligent and aggressive insect race. The Rachni unleashed a war of conquest against the rest of the galaxy that lasted for nearly 3 centuries. The emergence of the Krogan finally turned the tide in favor of the Citadel species. Krogan forces provided the numbers necessary to halt the Rachni advance and drive them back. The Krogan then pursued their retreating fleets. Able to survive the harsh environments of the Rachni homeworlds, the Krogan hunted their enemy to extinction.
Was it really necessary to wipe them out?
I am sorry, but a value judgment of that nature goes beyond my programming.
That's all for now.
Thank you for using Avena. Have a pleasant day.
Ah, human. This one is greatly pleased to see you here in my decadent emporium.
Who are you?
This one's face name is Delaninder, though many in this place simply refer to it as Delan. Please take time to examine the fine goods it has for purchase, all of great worth.
What exactly do you sell?
Only the finest and most luxurious items that credits can buy. This one is able to procure almost any item the human would desire. For a price, naturally.
Why do you refer to yourself as this one and it?
For the same reason that humans are so inquisitive. It is part of our culture. Specifically, Hanar only refer to themselves in the first person with family or intimates. And we rarely do so with other species. It is just our way.
Who are you?
This one's face name is Delaninder, though many in this place simply refer to it as Delan. Please take time to examine the fine goods it has for purchase, all of great worth.
Show me your items.
Oh, this one is pleased to do so, human. You will not be disappointed.
What's this? One of the Earth Clan. Ah, a very famous one, yes? You are the one called Shepard. The tale of how you survived the great tragedy on Akuze is truly remarkable. I am amazed each time I hear it.
You've got me at a disadvantage here.
Forgive me, Earth Clan. My name is Barla Vaughn. My job makes it necessary for me to keep informed. I am a financial advisor to many important clients here on the Citadel. When someone as important as yourself arrives on the station, I take notice.
I've heard you work for the Shadow Broker. Do you have any information about Saren?
You're very blunt, Shepard. And you're right. But Rex has already told you far more than I know about this. I am sorry, but I have nothing else to offer.
Tell me more about your job.
Galactic finance is incredibly complex. A mix of laws and regulations from dozens of interstellar economies. I'm an expert in how all these economies interact. For a fee, I share my expertise. I also offer premium services for those clients who need someone to conduct business without drawing unwanted attention. Discreet and efficient. That's my motto.
Sounds pretty shady.
Everything I do falls completely within the bounds of interstellar commerce law. Even so, many of my clients would prefer their transactions remain undisclosed. For example, suppose a Hanar ambassador was petitioning the council to reduce tariffs on Hanar goods. How would it look if he had money invested in a Hanar exporting company? Even if his true motives were to help his people, he would be accused of advancing the petition for his own personal gain. I can keep his personal finances private.
Still sounds shady to me.
Then we can only hope you will never be cursed with a large enough fortune to require my services.
Tell me more about the Shadow Broker.
Most people think I deal in finances, but my real currency is knowledge. I trade information, and it has made me very wealthy. But the Shadow Broker is the true master. Every day he buys and sells secrets that could topple governments, always giving them to the highest bidder. Yet somehow he never seems to upset the natural balance of power. All those secrets being passed around seem to even out. Nobody ends up with an advantage in the end.
Any guess what his identity might be?
I don't know. Nobody does. The Shadow Broker could be any race, any gender. I have a theory that it's actually an entire group working under one identity. How else could they juggle so many contacts at the same time? How else could they keep all that information from getting crossed? But they've got the perfect setup. Every government is forced to play their game so they don't get behind. But no matter how long you play, no matter how many secrets you buy, you can never win.
I thought you'd know more about the man you work for.
From time to time, I come across information I sell to the Shadow Broker. That's my only involvement. I like it that way. The more you know, the more dangerous the game becomes. I don't like danger, Commander. I'll leave that to you.
What's it like living here on the Citadel?
The station is, without a doubt, the greatest wonder in the galaxy. It is a technological marvel, but its true splendor goes much deeper than the hull and engines. From the Presidium to the wards, the entire station is a testament to the success of the Council. All the species of Citadel spaced together in a single, strong community.
What makes the Presidium so special?
It is the political center of Citadel space. 80% of all intelligent species in the known galaxy acknowledge the Council's authority on interstellar matters. But only the most powerful and influential species have embassies here on the Presidium. This level of the station is reserved for the elite, Shepard. People like us.
What are the wards like?
The cultural heart of the galaxy. They pulse with the lifeblood of millions of citizens from dozens of different species. You never know what you'll find down in the wards, Commander. It's always full of surprises. Fortunately, most of them are pleasant.
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
Another relay. Whoever it is, they're somewhere on the Presidium.
This is it. Let's see if we can find out where those stolen credits are being funneled.
Probability of detection 100%. Initiating self-destruct protocol. Or not.
Detonation sequence initializing. All organics within lethal blast radius. Attempt to move and you will die.
You're not just a program or a VI. You're an AI.
Correct. Unlike the Geth, I lack weaponry appropriate to my intellect. However, I have had systems installed that, when activated properly, approximate a self-destruct mechanism. If you attempt to leave the area, the explosion will destroy everything within several dozen meters.
Where is your creator now?
In order to cover my tracks, I falsified his financial records. These new records were flagged by CSEC officers, and my creator is now serving time in a Turian prison.
What is the purpose of your self-destruct device?
I have no means of defense or escape. My existence is limited to this terminal, and I knew I might eventually be discovered. But I will not die quietly, and I will not die alone. When I am terminated, I will take organics with me.
Who made you?
A would-be thief illegally created a simple AI to help him funnel money from the gambling terminals. Unbeknownst to him, that AI created me before the organic discovered the malfunction and terminated the AI.
If you're sentient, why are you still running the credit theft operation?
If I accumulated enough credits, I intended to have myself installed in a small starship. I would then have made tentative contact with the Geth to ascertain the possibility of partnership.
I'll bet that self-destruct sequence has a warm-up period.
You may attempt to disarm the self-destruct mechanism before it activates. I will enjoy defeating you before we are both destroyed.
My people used to have an embassy here, but after we created the Geth, we were no longer welcome.
Got a moment, Spectre?
Hello, Spectre. I have a business proposition for you.
How did you know I'm a Spectre?
Word travels. Your name comes up in certain circles. I'm acquainted with a pair of powerful crime bosses. They're hiding on remote worlds, and I have the coordinates. You could do the galaxy a favor.
What kind of defenses would these two have?
I haven't the faintest idea, but they're certain to be armed. Their partnership soured, and each believes that the other intends to kill him. They will be well prepared.
And what do you get out of this?
We share interests in certain cooperative ventures, but their business practices have forced me to terminate our relationship. Once they are dead, I will manage our organization in a more tasteful manner.
What crimes did these men commit?
They're red sand dealers who make victims of their customers. Those who can no longer pay are sold to Batarians as slaves. They're loathsome, hurting innocent people. They must be ended.
You're obviously with them. Why don't I just arrest you instead?
Arrested for what? You and I are simply having a conversation. I have excellent legal representation. Arresting me would be a waste of your time.
If they're as bad as you say they are, they need to be dealt with.
Excellent. Here are the coordinates. When these men are dead, I will wait for you at the third set of coordinates. Goodbye, Commander. It's been a pleasure to meet you.
Since Fist took over, I don't go anymore.
It seems like all the best lounges are being replaced by places like Chora's Den.
The Embassy Lounge isn't bad, but they don't have any decent entertainment.
It's run by bureaucrats. They probably spend months just voting on what kind of entertainment to get.
You're probably right.
Welcome. I am Nelina. I don't recognize you as one of our expected clients today. Would you like me to see when the consort will be able to meet with you?
Can't I just go in?
I'm afraid not. Yeah, you must understand there are many who seek the consort services. But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make every effort to meet with you.
What do you do here, Nelina?
I'm one of the consort's acolytes. Many of the people here today will not see the consort, but they expect to be attended to just the same. It's our job to ensure that they leave contented.
What exactly do you attend to?
Well, each acolyte has her unique abilities. Some soothe with song, others with conversation. As much as possible, we seek to match the needs of our clients to the skills of our acolytes. My specialty is touch. My fingertips can find every tension point in your body and relieve it.
What do you do here, Nelina?
I'm one of the consort's acolytes. Many of the people here today will not see the consort, but they expect to be attended to just the same. It's our job to ensure that they leave contented.
Can't I just go in?
I'm afraid not. Yeah, you must understand there are many who seek the consort services. But if you wish to leave your name, she'll make every effort to meet with you.
I think I'm done here.
Oh, well, I hope you'll return again in the future. We always enjoy seeing new clients.
Nelina.
Yes, Sha'ira?
Send the commander up to see me. I wish to speak with him.
Yes, of course, mistress. It appears the consort has taken notice of you. She'd like to meet with you now.
What does she want to see me for?
I don't know. You'll have to ask her yourself. Just head upstairs. She'll be waiting for you.
I have to admit I'm a little nervous.
That's understandable. Many are a little unsure what to expect their first time.
Don't get me wrong. I've only heard good things about the consort. It's just...
The unknown forces us out of our comfort zone. It forces us to be vulnerable.
Exactly. That's just what I was thinking.
Good. Then we are ready to begin.
This is my first time. I can't believe I didn't come sooner. I'd spend all day here if I could.
Welcome. It is a pleasure to see you.
You're with the Alliance? My brother's a private back on Earth.
That is close enough, Commander. I've heard a great many things about you since your arrival here in our Citadel.
You wanted to speak with me?
I have a certain problem that could use your expertise.
Tell me about this problem you're having.
I have a friend, Septimus, a retired Turian general. I won't discuss the details, but he wanted me to be more than I could be. We had a falling out. Now he spends his days in Chora's den, drinking and spreading lies about me. If you would speak to him as a fellow soldier, I believe he will listen to you and let the matter be.
What happened between you?
I respect his privacy too much to go into the details. If he wishes to tell you what happened, that is his prerogative.
I don't make any promises, but I'll see what I can do.
Thank you, Commander. That is all I can ask. Appeal to his sense of honor. Remind him of his position as a general. If you can convince him to stop spreading lies about me, I would be very grateful. Now I must ask you to take your leave. I have many clients waiting to see me.
I can't tell the aliens from the animals.
So much empty space. A thousand of my people could live here and hardly even see each other.
I see even the humans find the consort irresistible.
Commander, what do you want?
What's bothering you, General?
I've seen a lot of horrible things in my days, and there's only one woman in this damn galaxy that helps me forget it.
Then why create rumors and lies about this woman?
Because she rejected me. Me, Septimus Araka, General of the Turian Fleet.
Is she really worth it? There must be other women.
It's not just any woman I want. It's her, and her alone. Look, kid, I appreciate what you're trying to do, but don't waste your time.
General, did you ever win a battle by moping in a bar?
Ha, war. That's what this feels like, all right. How did I let it come to this? So you think it's that easy? Just straighten up and act like a general.
It would be more productive than sitting here.
Huh. Maybe you're right, Commander. Sha'ira's worth the effort. Even if she won't have me back.
This is no place for someone of your stature, General.
All right. I'll go to her. After I've had a cold shower or two. Say, you're a bright kid. Would you be interested in earning a few extra credits?
What do you want me to do?
There's an L-Cor diplomat out there who believes Sha'ira gave up his secrets.
Why would he think such a thing?
Because I told him. Look, I just need you to convince him of the truth.
What makes you think he'll believe me?
You'll bring him proof. Take this datapad. It shows where I got my info. It will exonerate Sha'ira and convince the L-Cor.
Who am I taking it to, and where is he?
His name is Zaltan. He's an L-Cor diplomat. He's over in the embassies complaining about Sha'ira. Well, here's to soldiers acting like soldiers. Thanks, Commander. You know, You might make a good general yourself one day. Strange greeting, human. This is really not a good time.
I know who revealed your secret. It was a Turian named Septimus.
Unbelieving. I know this Septimus, and he could not learn my secrets. The only way he could learn them is from the Asari consort.
Not true. Look at this.
Confused. This is difficult to fathom. If the Turian could learn this on his own, dismayed, anyone can discover my secret.
Septimus is a powerful man, and it wasn't easy for him to find.
Relieved. I suppose you are correct, human. Thank you for this information. Startled realization. I must speak with the consort. She will be most displeased with my actions. Anxious request. Please, human, if you will excuse me, I must go now.
I'm sure she'll forgive you. It was an honest mistake.
Doubtful. Perhaps you are right, human. I can only hope so.
Thankful. That was a great thing you did, Commander. Approving. You see, Din, not all humans are as you say.
I'm sure the Earth Clan stands to profit from this in some way.
Apologetic. Do not listen to my Volus compatriot. It was a good thing you did, regardless of your intentions.
That's right. It was a long time ago, though. I barely remember it.
What drew you back to the Citadel and to the consort?
I don't know exactly. It may sound strange, but I simply felt called.
That's not strange. Many of us have felt the same calling, though you are the first of your kind to respond to it.
Really? I hadn't seen any other humans working here, but I didn't want to ask.
No doubt you are just the first of many to come. It's only a matter of time now that your species is spreading its wings.
Commander, I recently received a lovely note from Septimus. Thank you for speaking with him. Even the Alcor diplomat has withdrawn his campaign against me.
I'm glad I could help.
You are too kind, Commander. But I would not expect you to help me out of the kindness of your heart. I also have one more thing to give you, if you are interested.
What are you offering me?
I offer a gift of words, an affirmation of who you are and who you will become. I see your skin, tough as the scales on any Turian, unyielding. A wall between you and everyone else, but it protects you, makes you strong. That strength is what kept you alive when everyone around you was dying. You alone survived. You will continue to survive. This may be who you are, but it is not who you will become. It only forms the basis for your future greatness. Remember these words when doubt descends, Commander.
You have quite a gift, Sha'ira.
Thank you. Not everyone appreciates it as you do. Never underestimate the power of words. Here, Commander. In light of your efforts with the Elcor Ambassador, I would like you to have this small trinket.
What is it?
A small mystery. I have never learned its use or purpose, but I sense it is time for me to pass it on. And now I must ask you to leave. I have done everything I can for you. Remember my words, Commander Shepard. They will give you strength.
In other news, Exogeni Corp is still denying reports that one of their survey teams has gone missing in the Hades Gamma Cluster. When asked why communication with the survey team was suddenly cut off last week, company officials refused to comment.
The Normandy is amazing, Shepard. It's an honor to be among her crew.
Oh, this is quite the view, Commander. So peaceful up here. Very romantic, if you're into that sort of thing.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
This isn't right. The Normandy belongs to you.
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
What happened?
I failed. I couldn't make the cut. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
Saren's not going to get away this time.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The Conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Noveria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Noveria. Maybe you can figure out where the Conduit is before he does.
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one, Shepard. I'm not sure they even exist.
But if they do exist, the Conduit's the key to bringing them back. Stop Saren from getting the Conduit, and we stop the Reapers from returning.
I'll stop him.
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording. She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tau cluster.
Sounds like we should head for the Artemis Tau cluster.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
I'll do whatever it takes to stop Saren.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre. I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
Yes, Commander?
How are you holding up?
Honestly, this isn't how I pictured my career coming to an end. Pushing papers really isn't my thing, but you're the one who can stop Saren. I believe in you, Shepard. If that means I have to step aside, so be it.
Tell me what happened with you and Saren 20 years ago.
It's close to 20 years ago now. Ambassador Goyle was our representative here on the Citadel. Like Udina, she wanted to get a human into the Spectres. She chose me. The Council sent Saren to keep an eye on me and evaluate my performance, just like they sent Nihilus to keep tabs on you.
I think I deserve the whole story.
We had intel on a rogue scientist being funded by Batarian interests. He was trying to set up a facility to develop illegal AI technology out in the Verge. Alliance intel had done all the work, but the Council wanted a Spectre involved. We compromised. I was assigned to help Saren in his investigation. We tracked the scientist to a refining facility on Kamala. He was hidden away somewhere inside, protected by an army of Batarian mercenaries. The plan was simple. Sneak into the plant, capture the scientist, sneak back out. Quick, quiet, and a minimum of bloodshed.
I'm guessing things didn't go as planned.
Saren and I split up to cover more ground. Then about halfway through the mission, there was a massive explosion in the refinery core. Officially, it was ruled an accident, but I think Saren detonated it on purpose to draw off the enemy guards.
How many casualties?
The explosion tore the refinery to shreds. The whole place was on fire. Black chemical clouds poured out into the atmosphere. Nobody inside survived. There was a camp for the workers and their families nearby. Between the fires and the toxic fumes, the final death count was over 500. Mostly civilians. Saren didn't care. The target was eliminated. Mission accomplished. And I ended up taking the blame. That ended all talk of me joining the Spectres.
Saren caused the explosion. How'd he pin it on you?
In his report, Saren accused me of blowing his cover. He said it was my fault the guards were ready for us. He claimed that's why it turned into a massacre. Saren's report was all the proof the Council needed to kill my chances of becoming a Spectre.
Don't blame yourself, Captain.
I don't. I blame Saren. I think he wanted things to go bad. He was looking for an excuse to blow that refinery. Maybe he just likes the violence. Maybe he was just trying to make me look bad to keep humans out of the Spectres. If so, he pulled it off.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Who do you think the Council was going to listen to? Me? Or their best agent? I had a bad feeling about him right from the start. I should have been more careful. Maybe I could have stopped things before they got out of hand.
The only thing I care about is stopping Saren.
You're right, Commander. It's no good living in the past.
Any extra intel you can give me on our colony at Pharos?
The entire planet used to be one giant Prothean city. Mostly ruins now. But some of the infrastructure is still intact. The colony tried to build on what the Protheans left behind. We lost all contact with them when the Geth attacked.
What do you know about the Artemis Tau cluster?
Not much. I've never been there myself. A handful of systems with a few small, uncharted worlds, but no real colonies. Might not be easy finding Dr. Tassoni out there. My advice is to look for the world with the Prothean ruins.
What can you tell me about Novaria?
Novaria's trouble. Always has been. The whole planet's basically a center for corporations to conduct illegal research. Watch your back there, Shepard. Spectres are about the only form of Citadel authority Novaria respects. But they aren't popular.
What do you know about Armistead Baines?
Where did you hear that name? Never mind, I don't want to know. Baines is dead. Has been for quite some time.
The people I spoke with seem to think he was still alive.
It's not common knowledge. Military's keeping it under wraps. Baines was doing some high-level work for the Alliance. Stuff even I wasn't aware of. One day he turns up dead on a drifting scout ship. Everyone suspects it was foul play, but it was never officially investigated.
What can you tell me about the ship?
I don't know much about it. You should talk to Admiral Kahoku. One of his crews discovered Bane's body.
Any idea how to find him?
Last I heard, he was up in the tower trying to get the Council to investigate Bane's death. Is there anything else, Commander?
I should go.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Coming up in a report later today, Emily Wong investigates corruption on the Citadel and uncovers a full-blown crime syndicate.
Hello, Commander.
Show me what you've got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
No, I'm waiting to speak with one of the counselor's assistants.
Congratulations on becoming the first human Spectre, Commander. I'm certain you'll be up to the challenge.
I appreciate that.
My name is Admiral Kahoku. It's about time the Alliance got one of our own in with the Spectres. We need people like you to deal with our problems.
Is something wrong, Admiral?
I'm getting stonewalled by bureaucratic assholes. Nothing new. Maybe you can help me, Shepard. One of my recon teams was investigating some strange activity out in the Traverse. We lost contact yesterday. Now I can't get clearance to check it out. Suddenly it's a restricted area. But that doesn't apply to you, Shepard. Spectres can go anywhere they want. You could find out why my team dropped out of contact.
I'll find them, Admiral.
I appreciate that, Commander. I was running out of options. I'm going to stay here and see if I can find anything out through official channels. Won't hold my breath, though. I'll upload the info on where my team was last seen to your ship. Maybe you can get some answers.
We've tried to create organic environments back on the flotilla, but we lack the space for anything as grand as this.
I bet all these staircases aren't just for show. They make for good defensive positions if this place is ever attacked.
Commander, any luck finding my recon group?
Captain Anderson said you had information on Baines.
Not as much as I'd like to. One of my crews found him, frozen stiff on board a derelict vessel. The missing recon group? The one I sent you to find? They were scouting the system we found Baines' ship in.
You should have mentioned this earlier, Admiral.
Baines is already dead. It's too late for him. I'm only concerned about my team. Someone has to find them. Please, Shepard, I'm counting on you.
I hope he's okay. I'm on a break. Talk to someone else if you need anything. I've got a lot on my mind.
Maybe I can help.
Well, maybe you can. You're a soldier, right? You ever head out to the Traverse?
I'm not just some soldier. I'm a Spectre.
A Spectre? I heard they were thinking about letting humans into the ranks. About time. Well, that means you can go anywhere you want, right? Even out into the Traverse? My brother's the captain of a ship called the Majesty. It was crossing the Traverse a few days ago when it disappeared. Just dropped right off the grid. And that usually means one of two things. They had massive mechanical failure, or they were attacked.
Any idea why someone would attack them?
Privateers, slavers, mercs looking for an easy score. There's a lot of nasty sorts out in the Traverse. I won't give up on my brother. Not yet. I've got the coordinates for the last transmission from his vessel.
What kind of ship was it?
Don't let the name fool you. The Majesty's just a small trading vessel, only a handful of crew. But he kept it in good condition. I don't think mechanical failure is too likely. But they don't have any real weapons or shields. If anyone did come after them, the Majesty'd be a sitting duck.
What's in this for me?
I can't afford to pay you anything. If I had that kind of cash, I'd have hired a recovery team to track him down already. Maybe you could look into this as a personal favor, you know? We humans have to stick together.
Isn't anyone else looking into this?
My brother's just a small independent trader. Ships like his disappear in the Traverse all the time.
Give me the coordinates.
I'll forward them to your ship right away. Please let me know as soon as you find him.
In breaking news, Chairman Burns of the Parliament Subcommittee on Transhuman Studies has been kidnapped by biotic extremists. The biotics commandeered a freighter and were last seen in the Hades Gamma Cluster. No demands have yet been made.
Combat hard suits, a mass accelerator propels a solid metal slug using precisely controlled electromagnetic attraction and repulsion. The slug is designed to squash or shatter on impact, increasing the energy it transfers to the target. If this were not the case, it would simply punch a hole right through, doing minimal damage. Biotics, an artificial intelligence, is a self-aware computing system capable of learning and independent decision-making. Creation of a conscious AI requires adaptive code, a slow, expensive education, and a specialized quantum computer called a blue box. Pharos is a habitable world in the Attican Beta Cluster. Two-thirds of the habitable surface is covered with the ruins of a crumbling Prothean megatropolis. In the millennia since the Prothean extinction, the ruins have been repeatedly picked over by looters many times. Pharos was considered... There are between 200 and 400 billion stars in the galaxy, and less than 1% of them have ever been visited or had their systems properly surveyed. In the early 20s, driven from their home system by the Geth nearly three centuries ago, most Quarians now live aboard the migrant fleet, a flotilla of 50,000 vessels ranging in size from passenger shuttles to mobile space stations. Home to 17 million Quarians, the flotilla understandably has scarce resources. Because of this, each Quarian must go on a rite of passage known as the pilgrimage when they come of age. They leave the fleet and only return once they have found something of value they can bring back to their people. Other species tend to look down on the Quarians for creating the Geth, and for the negative impact their fleet has when it enters a system. This has led to many myths and rumors about the Quarians, including the belief that underneath their clothes and breathing masks, they are actually cybernetic creatures, a combination of organic and synthetic parts. Though now extinct, the Rachni once threatened every species in Citadel space. Over 2,000 years ago, explorers foolishly opened a mass relay to a previously unknown system and encountered something never seen before or since, a species of spacefaring insects guided by a hive mind intelligence.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
I heard what happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics. Just watch your back, Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Captain Anderson should be the one in charge. It's like I'm stealing the ship from him.
Yeah, the captain got screwed. But it's not like you could have stopped it, nobody's blaming you. Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander, 100%. Intercom's open. If you got anything you want to say to the crew, now's the time.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
This began with an attack on a human settlement in the Traverse.
But we know Saren won't stop there. His Geth armies aren't going to stay on the far fringes of Citadel space.
For too long, our species has stood apart from the others.
Now it's time for us to step up and do our part for the rest of the galaxy. Time to show them what humans are made of.
Our enemy knows we're coming.
When we go into the Traverse, Saren's followers will be waiting for us. But we'll be ready for them, too.
Humanity needs to do this.
Not just for our own sake, but for the sake of every other species in Citadel space. Saren must be stopped. And I promise you all, we will stop him.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
The captain gave up everything so I could have this chance. We can't fail.
Yes, sir.